It seems like every time anybody drops an album these days, every single video that uses that song talks about, oh, this is album of the year, this is album of the year. And yet when the time for the Grammys rolls around, you never see any of those albums anywhere but the rap album of the year category. Rap is one of the most popular genres of music in America today, but it seems like the Grammys disagree. So let's take a dive into the surprisingly deep rabbit hole of why the Grammys never nominate rap albums.
Everybody want to know what I would do if I didn't win.
If you're Metro, don't trust you, I'm gonna shoot.
Beautiful morning, yeah, the sun in my morning bed.
Let's start off by looking at the issue. When looking at Record of the Year, even as far back as 1980, there's only one singular rap record on the entire timeline. This is America by Childish Gambino.
This is America. Don't catch you slipping up. Don't catch you slipping up.
Not only is this his third most popular song, but it's marginally worse than his best works, at least in my opinion. And when we're looking at Album of the Year nominees, it's even worse. Since 2009, out of the 75 different Grammy Album of the Year nominees, only 13 can even be considered rap, and that's with me being pretty generous as to what counts as rap.
This one goes out to all the lovers. What can we do?
On top of that, there's only one year that has multiple rap nominations, and yet no album has ever won Album of the Year. And while there have been some successes with various other awards, and yeah, I know there's a whole category for rap that, you know, is supposed to be for that, but why can't rap win those big awards? Why can't they win Album of the Year or Record of the Year? It doesn't make any sense to me how artists like Kanye with 24 wins, Jay-Z with also 24, and people like Kendrick Lamar with 17 wins can't win the Album of the Year or Record of the Year award, which is really the one that matters the most. An easy assumption is that rap isn't a popular enough genre. This is obviously not the case. Rap is the most streamed genre on the largest streaming platforms in the world, and in 2021, 30% of all streams came from this genre alone in streaming globally. Rappers also dominate the charts with over 119 songs hitting the number one on the Billboard Hot 100. Billions of streams come from rap each year from around the globe. So that's definitely not the issue. Okay, well what about individual artists? Wrong again. Drake is the most streamed artist on Spotify.
What's your best feature?
I have a really, really big butt.
Of all time. Travis Scott's Utopia reached a billion streams on Spotify in less than 20 days. And yet, popularity doesn't even seem to be a factor when voting for album or song of the year. I mean, they let We Are by Jon Batiste win over Donda in 2022. I mean, who the fuck even is Jon Batiste? I can't even say his name. I legitimately have never heard of this fool before I started doing research for this video. He's got 2 million monthly listeners on Spotify, and he beat Kanye West at the Grammys.
Gotcha. Gotcha.
What the fuck? There are plenty more examples of really good and really popular albums and songs being completely ignored by the Grammy committee. And that Grammy committee is the source of the issue. It seems like they cherry pick rap albums to nominate just to say that they have one. And you know what? That's actually what I think they're doing. On the Grammy website, I saw this blurb explaining how they have, quote, from gutsy pop to psychedelic soul, the 8 nominees for Album of the Year at the 2024 Grammys, which are notably dominated by women, people of color, and the queer community, are a reflection of the joyous diversity within the music community. And don't get me wrong, I have no problem letting women, people of color, or anyone in the LGBTQ+ community winning the Grammys. And you shouldn't either. Representation in music is super important, being able to listen to people who have the same experience as you or look like you or anything else like that is super important, and I think in general representation is a really, really positive thing. But here's the thing. The Grammy committee is not being representative of people. And specifically, it's not being representative of the youth of America.
Do you guys watch Skibbity Toilet?
Yes, I know
Skibbity Toilet. Can you guys sing it? Can you guys sing it?
Every year they pick artists that just don't reflect the musical tastes of a very massive majority of Americans. The Grammys have basically decided that they are more concerned with their public and media image than they are with actually giving artists who make good music actual awards. And once again, I'm not saying that the albums that win Album of the Year are made by bad musicians. I'm not saying that they're not talented people. What I am saying is that they are purposely ignoring some people that do make very good music. They're allowing outside influences to essentially make their decisions bias, and it really creates this environment where very talented artists aren't getting the recognition that they do deserve, like everyone else. It just proves how bad and out of touch the Grammys are. They talk about diversity, but then just completely ignore one of the most dynamic and diverse communities in music history. Rap is one of those things that is just so incredible. It's being listened to people of all ages, all colors, and from places all across the entire United States and the world. Rap is amazing because it allows people from completely different backgrounds to connect over something that really is just amazing and is a great, very tasteful art form. So I think it's time we left the Grammys in the past and found a new, better way of judging Album of the Year. They obviously do not have a good taste. So thank you guys for watching this video, and also thank you guys for watching my last video so much. I mean, it's already got like 10k views and has almost like quadrupled or like a huge number my subscribers. Like I literally had like 30 subscribers a week ago, and now I'm sitting at 200 people already. And I know it's gonna probably get a lot bigger after this video comes out, but I just want to thank you guys. The support has been absolutely crazy, and I really would not be doing this if it wasn't for you guys. So thank you so much. This is like my dream come true.